Very good morning to all the children, beta. So we are going to start new chapter, Making of a Scientist. Though it is in the term 2, but we are having much syllabus to be covered up later on. That's why we decided all the chapters of term 1 are covered enough, fine. So it's very chapter with difficult terminology. It's on page 32 of your footprints without feet. So I have written a few value points. The making of a scientist. How Richard Ebright became a scientist. So basically this chapter is a journey. That how many students, you know, they keep on thinking that, okay, that child is very intelligent. This child, you know, keeps on grabbing the position. Why cannot I be at the first place? Or how can I also do this experiment and all? So, you know, there is no particular formula of success. There is just one formula to success. Your roots, your base. If your base is strong enough, the building erected on it will be very strong. Similarly, the kind of childhood Ebright was having, and how his mother single-handedly raised this boy, and how she taught him the basic education and the values she imbibed in him, and how she made sure. So the seed, you can say the germination of the seed was done when he was a child only. You know, his mother, you know, she keeps on collecting resources and books related to butterflies and other things. It created curiosity in his mind. And then even as a, you can say, when he was very young, he started noticing the butterflies, their movement, their color. And then at very young age, when he was in his early 20s, when people just complete their college or when they enter into college, at that time, he became one of the, you can say, scientists only. So he experimented something with one of the hormones. So I've written how Richard Ebright became a scientist. This is the story. Very inspirational. He had very tough circumstances. You were saying that's very difficult. The kind of life he was having, you will read about it. Thorough knowledge of monarch butterflies, one of the species beta of butterflies. Since childhood, he was having this knowledge. Found an unknown hormone in the gold spots of butterflies. So he was the first scientist who made announcement about some hormone. And then he was the person and he was awarded for this later on. And when children, you know, they're exploring the world, they have all the WH questions that why, what, how, ye kaise ho raha hai. And rather than snubbing them, give answer back to them. And see where their interest is. Explore your interest. So after 10th, you people will be very confused. Whether should I choose science for me? Science is a very noble stream. If I choose science, it will be very, you know, people will be praising me. Okay, he's a science student. So rather than thinking in that way, firstly, you find your aptitude. Have you heard about the aptitude tests? Let me tell you, you should know. Aptitude tests, it means, this word means interest. Aptitude means interest. In which stream you are having aptitude? There are many aptitude tests conducted. When you appear into these tests, various questions, objective questions will be there, streaming different branches of knowledge. They check your interest. So at the end, when you score more in particular genre, वहां से पता लग जाता है क्योंकि इस बच्चे का इंटरेस्ट इस स्ट्रीम में है और इस सेगमेंट ऑफ सब्जेक्ट में है. फाइन. सो दैट एप्टीट्यूड टेस्ट हाइलाइट्स दैट. यू कैन गो फॉर एप्टीट्यूड टेस्ट और अनदर वे इज यू योरसेल्फ शुड नो वेयर डू आई स्टैंड. यू आर गुड एट साइंसेस प्लस यू हैव इंटरेस्ट ऑल्सो. बोथ थिंग्स रिक्वायर. इफ यू आर गुड एट इट बट यू डू नॉट हैव इंटरेस्ट, यू विल डू थिंग्स हाफ हार्टेडली. आपका इंटरेस्ट नहीं है, पेरेंट्स ने जबरदस्ती से साइंस ले दिया बिकॉज दे वॉन्ट यू टू बिकम अ डॉक्टर एंड यू डू नॉट हैव इंटरेस्ट. यू हैव इंटरेस्ट इन सिंगिंग you are a very good singer, you can play various instruments, but they are not allowing you, that is also, you can say, misleading to you. So you should find your aptitude first. Where is your interest? Second is capability. Are you capable of fulfilling your interest? Both things, then you should decide your career. So this boy, when he was very young, he was having interest in scientific experiments. His mother explored it, found it, and she started supporting it since childhood. She started bringing him books based on butterflies. She started writing, making him participate in various activities. You know, you people run away from activities now because you're burdened with education and textual books only. But you never know which activity will change your future. Fine, you are participating in one of the UA program. Maybe you can be a, you can go in mass communication. You don't know. The, you can say branches of mass communication are quite bigger ones. They teach you how to hold camera. You know that even girls in, we have in HMB college and DAV and many other colleges, they're providing the mass comm and journalism is a subject. Reporter banna, it's not an easy thing. It's a proper subject. They tell you girls are holding cameras and mics and going and taking interviews, going to various channels and all. You know, I'm just saying, if your interest is there, whether you're a boy or a girl, if your interest is there, you know, grow that interest rather than snubbing it. Watering the plants karte ho na, wo karna padega. You have to water your interest and let it grow and see how successful you become. Very few people are there who become, you can say, they follow their interest and their profession is same. Getting my point? If your interest, what you want to become, and what you become, it is same. You are the most luckiest person. Clear? And it can happen with all your choice you make and how you follow the path. So this boy, his mother helped him a lot, right? He found an unknown hormone in the gold sports. So this is the, it is the basic value points. Let me tell you about the theme. The theme of this chapter is based on, write down. Yes, beta, all clear to children sitting at home? Send me thumbs up. If it is clear, what we are going to read. Fine. So, talking about. Yes, beta. Voice at last. Encourage the young learners. Theme is encourage the young learners. Why I write in capital letters? So that children attending classes with the help of a mobile, a small gadget, can read it. Fine, that is the reason I usually write in capital letters. Encourage the young learners for their inclination for, yes, boys, who wants to come here? Now you are fine, Dishant. You were not feeling well a few moments later, few moments ago. Encourage the young learners for their inclination. Towards. Whatever that young learner is having inclination to. If he wants to learn to play guitar, let him play. If he wants to learn acting, let him go into that. If a person wants to read science books, let him read that. Last boy, please behave. So encourage the young learners, those who are at very young age, of your age or even younger than that, let them explore their interests, fine. Second theme is, inculcate the habits, write down, inculcate the habits from beginning onwards, from you cannot think the child is just three. अभी नहीं इसको कुछ करवाना. You know that foreigners, they just ready to make their 6 month old, you can say, young kid, they let him swim on his own with the help, guiding, because they say that up to the age of 5, 70% of the brain gets developed by the age of 5. When child crosses the age of 5 or 6, he starts exploring the things on his own. Fine, then he will be adding his own learnings into it. 30% is rest of the things, whatever he'll be gaining. So when they are young enough, whatever habits they will acquire from us, it's up to us how we manage it. Young learners are having the more inclination, or you can say more probabilities there that they can learn anything. There is a girl named Pavni in your school. She is a national level swimmer. Anybody of you knows? She started swimming when she was just 2. Pavni Bhatia of your school. I'm talking now. She is in this building only. I guess first or second. I don't exactly know the class. But when she was just 2 years old, she started learning swimming. Her parents kept on guiding her. Because her father was a national level swimmer, maybe. He kept on guiding her, encouraged her, and now she has won a lot of medals in the name of that championships of swimming under the category of under 6 age, under 5, and there are very less number of children who are proficient in swimming at this age. Because parents are supporting it. Misuse of mask. Fine. For talking. I'll just be asking you to leave the class now. Only 2 boys are talking in the whole row. Let's start. Richard Ebright. Better let me share the screen with you all if you have noted down all the points. Kindly bring your books. You can bring those sitting at home. Yes, just listen carefully. Those who do not have books today, kindly bring it tomorrow. Richard Ebright has received the Searle Scholar Award and the Skirring Plow Award for Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Shift back to last desk. Shift back. Daksh, shift back. Yes, you also come here. Yes, आपको यहीं पे बिठाया था मैंने. जल्दी आओ. It was his fascination for butterflies that opened the world of science to him. Clear? At the age of 22, a former scout of the year excited the scientific world with a new theory on how cells work. Richard H. Ebright and his college roommate explained the theory in an article underlined in the proceedings of the National Academy of Science. So this is the name of one of the articles published and written by them. It was the first time this important scientific journal had ever published the work of college students. First time in history, an article by college students was being published in a science journal. What is a journal? It is record of inventions by some people. Fine. But a scout is a, you can say, an activity in which you participate. When you will be in college, scout and guide, there will be some activity in which they will be giving you proper uniform and you will be doing many activities just like the way army people do. You know, they give you experiences, camping ke liye jaate hain wo bache, NCC, fine. So these kinds of things, scout guides and all. So he was very bright child. He was considered, he was declared scout of the year also. So they are saying ki first time ever that college students' work was being published in one of the scientific journals. In sports, that would be like making the big leagues at the age of 15 and hitting a home run your first time at bat. Meaning of this expression is written at the footnotes of the book. A home run in the game of baseball is when the batter scores a run. So this is the scientific term, running a home. In baseball, he was very good at baseball also in this sports at the age of 15 only. For Richard E. Bright, it was the first in a long string of achievements in science and other fields, and it all started with butterflies. Now they're going to start how he became a scientist. It all started with butterflies. He was having interest in butterflies. An only child. He did not have any sibling. Uska na koi brother tha na koi sister. He was only child. E. Bright grew up north of Reading, Pennsylvania. This is the name of the place where he was born. There was not much I could do there, he said. I certainly could not play football or baseball with a team of one. So being single child, he did not have any playmate. He said, but there was one thing I could do. So, jo single child hote hain, unke liye problem bhi hota hai. If they do not have any sibling to play with, they have to find games which they can play all alone. If they do not have any company in surrounding areas also. So, his mother making him into the habit of collecting things. So, at the very young age, E. Bright started collecting things. What did he collect? Let's see. So he did, and did he ever? Beginning in kindergarten, KG, fine. E. Bright collected butterflies with the same determination that has marked all his activities. He also collected rocks, fossils, and coins. He became an eager astronomer too, sometimes stargazing all night. So underline, when he was in KG only, he started, you know, looking at various inventions, star constellations, various stars and various rocks and parts of stones. He started collecting, fine, and coins of various countries. So he was having interest into collecting the things, and he started collecting butterflies. He was not killing them. He was collecting and maybe putting it in some space where he could see them. From the first, he had a driving curiosity along with a bright mind. He also had a mother who encouraged his interest in learning. So now we are going to read about the role of his mother. She took him on trips, bought him telescopes, microscopes, cameras, mounting materials, and other equipment, and helped him in many other ways. She was the first. Mother is the first guru. Mother knows the child in every aspect. Usko ye bhi pata hota ki mera bachcha mereko jhoot bol raha hai. And she will never let you know that she knows that you are telling her a lie. Fine, mother knows every bit of, you are part of your mother only. Fine. She is not only the biological mother to you. She is mother of your senses. She is the one who taught you how to speak, how to walk. And she knows what you want without even uttering a word. So when Ibrahim's mother noticed her son's interest in collection of various items, she thought, I should give, you know, the way we plant a tree, we have to give watering, seeds and everything, fertilizers, we have to put it inside it. She brought telescope so that he can see insects and butterflies with the help of telescope. Cameras to click pictures. Whatever material was required, she made it available for her. Fine. So she was the main. Bell has gone, beta. So we are going to end this. Have a nice day.